Michelle here with Poetry Saved My Life. Today we are continuing with our American Poet series. This time we are featuring Mr. Shel Silverstein. And Shel Silverstein, if you don't know, is or was a prolific writer. He wrote lots of volumes of poetry, mainly for children. He did also write some prose. He is probably most known for this volume, Where the Sidewalk Ends, and also The Giving Tree. The Giving Tree is super popular, was and is still super popular, so you may be familiar with that work of his. I love his poetry in that it is for children, so it's entertaining, it's funny, it rhymes, but it also a lot of times says something, and it's also usually really poignant and just brilliant. I just think he was very brilliant. He also does his own illustrations in his poetry books, and they are funny and crude and look like something that a kid would draw, and I think that's on purpose. I think that's the appeal of it, so that, you know, it speaks to the children who are reading the books. This particular volume of poetry, Where the Sidewalk Ends, is my favorite out of all of his collections for kids. And I think that just is because I fell in love with it as a kid. Back in the day when we used to have library day, you know, our specials in elementary school, and we had books on cassette back then, there was only a couple cassettes in little cubicles that you could, you know, if you were one of the first kids to get in there, you could put a cassette in and the big old earphones and, you know, listen to a book on tape, actual, you know, tape, cassette tape. And that's when I first heard Where the Sidewalk Ends and Shel Silverstein was narrating the poems. And I just loved it as a kid. And so every time we had library, I would race in there to try to get to it before anybody else. And I've been reading these to my kids ever since. They've loved them. And, you know, they're older now, but I know they still love them, and I hope they'll, you know, pass that along to their children. I actually love him so much, I have a tattoo, and I'll try to get a better picture of it for you, on my wrist here. This is the candelabra that is in the opening poem, that, and we're going to do that one today. In the book, Where the Sidewalk Ends. That's the illustration, if you can see, in the book, to the poem Invitation. And I love this poem because it is so much what I think writing is. It's an invitation for us to immerse ourselves in stories and words, and everyone's welcome, and, you know, I try to live my life that way. I think that's the best part of life, is experiencing stories and telling stories and hearing stories and reading stories. And I love that for that. And also my daughter, my oldest daughter, when she was 2 years old, she had the invitation memorized. She was quite a precocious little toddler. And because I would always read, not always, but often would read poems out of this book and other Shel Silverstein books, rather than, you know, just fairy tales and whatnot for kids. And she liked this one and memorized it, and she'd always recite it, you know, before bedtime. And so I have the little tattoo, kind of reminds me of her when she was little. She's all grown up now, so. So that's a little backstory on Shel Silverstein, what he means to me. Backstory on him, he was born in 1930 in Chicago, so near my neck of the woods, and died there also in 1999. A lot of people don't know this, but aside from being a poet, he was also a songwriter, and he wrote A Boy Named Sue, which, if you know anything about Johnny Cash, that was one of his most famous songs, and he was a Grammy winner, I think, for that song and maybe some other songs. So he was very, you know, talented, multi-talented, could write for adults and for kids. So pretty cool. So today, like I mentioned, we're going to do Invitation, which is from Where the Sidewalk Ends. If you don't have this book, I really, really recommend you get it, or check it out from the library and, you know, give it a whirl, and then I'm sure you're going to want to buy it after that. If you can get a hold of the CD, now it's a CD, of him reading the poetry, if you have kids, do it, because he is so funny and expressive, and it's just great. I actually don't have it, but I did put it on hold at the library, so as soon as they get it in, I'm going to bring it. Maybe I'll play some of it on the channel, because it's really great. So, okay, without further ado, invitation. Invitation. If you are a dreamer, come in. If you are a dreamer, a wisher, a liar, a hoper, a prayer, a magic bean buyer, if you're a pretender, come sit by my fire, for we have some flax golden tales to spin. Come in, come in. So like I said, I love this one. It's it is exactly what it's called. It's an invitation to enjoy the written word, to enjoy stories. It's inclusive. Come in, come in, come in and enjoy. It's an introduction to the book, to, you know, the joy of reading, of storytelling, of poetry. So I just love it. I hope you enjoyed it. Please give me some comments down below and let me know what you thought of it. If you loved it, hated it, what you think of Shel Silverstein. And, you know, I hope you will stay tuned for the next episode and get a little bit more of Mr. Silverstein. I hope you have a lovely poetic day.